The gentleman will follow.
Captain!
Report, 4th Kite Squadron. The Fundsberg Division as a whole. Deserters.
Does General Voorhis know?
He's at the briefing. They're not letting anyone in.
Nonsense.
Tell him show where I.
The Redanians will
this
be here.
Imperial Majesty,
this decision must be taken now.
Speak. Ciri is dead.
How did it happen?
The White Cold. You're familiar with the prophecy? Ciri tried to stop it. She did, but paid the ultimate price.
Where is the body?
I doubt it'll ever be found.
Who else knows?
Avalach, Elven Sage. But I doubt you'll find him either.
And Yennefer?
She's decided to stay in the north. Provided you don't object.
I don't. And you?
Plenty of work for witchers after a war. I'll travel east, maybe north.
Did Cirilla say... Did she ask you to convey anything?
She regretted not getting a chance to say goodbye.
Did she tell you this? Really?
Didn't have to. She wanted to make peace. I know that. If there's nothing else...
There is, but you may go. Witcher. I do not wish to see you ever again.
Need a hand with your wagon?
No. It's not exactly ours. More a captured vehicle. Booty, you might say.
Folk must have abandoned it in their rush. To where, I don't know. Be a shame for the Reds to claim it, loot it.
Change is coming.
Grown accustomed, we have.
With the Black Ones gone, witch hunters will move in. Yet life will roll on. We've to seize the day.
True that. So, let's get to work before night creeps up on us.
Sure you don't need any help?
I believe we will manage.
Where are you headed? Nearest inn, by the looks of it.
Yeah. Supposed to meet someone first, at the former campsite of the Nilfgaardians. You take care now.
Master Ort.
Probably got held back. You're late.
Soldiers.
Blocking the roads, I know. No matter. You have it?
As agreed. 38.5-inch blade. Weight, just under 40 ounces. Silver-plated siderite steel core. Glyphs and runes both the length of the blade and on the hilt.
Beautiful.
Been in this trade for 3 decades. Only the best swordsman of the calling for my wares. When I say no Witcher has, or ever had, a better weapon, you ought to trust me.
Reputation precedes you, Master Ort. I'd never doubt you.
The inscription, as you asked.
Zirael. Swallow.
Classic Elder Speech runes, no styling, simple and precise.
May I?
It is yours. If you'd like to test it, had my lackeys put out a training dummy.
Mm-hmm. Your payment. Gems only, as requested.
If you've an eye out for work, heard a Striggers prowling the Maribor Forest.
Thanks. Need to visit the tavern first, but after, who knows?
Good luck on the path, Witcher.
Is it done?
Yes.
Did he believe you?
I have no idea.
For the cockatrice. And we've a new contract. It won't pay much, but I think it worth the toil.
You've been busy. It's yours.
A witcher's sword. Swallow. Ooh, beautiful. May I?
Not here. You'll have ample opportunity soon enough, Witcher.
Let's try it out then.
Radovid had many faults. He was cruel, impetuous, and pathologically ambitious. But he was a tactical genius. That's undeniable. Commanding forces far outnumbered by his foes, he handily defeated the invader from the south. The Redanian Eagle spread its wings, taking all the north, including Novigrad, beneath them. With victory in the war against Nilfgaard secured, Radovid proceeded to complete his witch hunt. As they had in Novigrad, pyres burned in Temeria and Edirn, lands now liberated by the Redanian monarch. In the drive for moral renewal, simple herbalists, pellers, healers, and non-humans, all supposed heretics, were murdered in droves. For many, freedom beneath Radovid's scepter proved more tragic than servitude to another. As long as his armies went from one victory to the next, Emir's subjects remained boundlessly obedient. When a string of humiliating defeats proved Var Emry's fallible, the opposition, thus far a secret, attacked. The subjects of the Emperor who had danced on the graves of his foes laid him to rest in a tomb of his own. Many islanders believed Svanrigga would be no more than his ambitious mother's puppet. The young king proved them wrong, ignoring her whims and ruling with an iron hand all his own. Tired of the Jarls and their endless feuds, he resolved to turn the Isles into an absolute monarchy, modeled after those of the continent. What he resolved, he achieved, but only by shedding his countrymen's blood. Cirilla Fiona Ellen Rhiannon, heir to Nilfgaard's throne, chose the life of a witcher on the path. Geralt taught her all he knew, every skill he possessed, then each set off on their own. Soon, word of the ashen-haired witcheress had spread throughout the north, from the Yoruga to the mountains of Kovir. And what of Geralt, you might ask? Well, he continued on as before, living hand to mouth, job to job, on the road, ever coinless. We would meet at times over a glass of strong drink to talk about the old days and speculate what could have, would have, might have been.
Yeah, I might believe you if you showed me a pair of monogrammed Batiste Galagaskins. More likely, you just say I stole them.
Dimwits.
Can I get you more of that hooch you praised so high yesterday?
Nah, gotta go. Promised I'd be at the huntsman's cottage at the crack of dawn.
Oh, aye, that's right. Rabbit hunting.
Mm-hmm.
Dad always had a soft spot for me. He could sense I was a family man. A man of peace. Good nature, like himself. Would have never crossed his mind to disown me if it wasn't for that hag I call my sister.
What's her name again? Count Julian Alfonso de what?
Viscount Julian Alfred Pancratz de Lettenhove. Don't believe me? Just watch. You'll wipe that doubting leer off your face when we go visit my estates.
You just invent this count bit. Quite the imagination for one who's sober.
Geralt will vouch for me. Tell him, I've always said I'm a count.
True. You have always said so.
Just nobody's bothered to verify it.
What's with this count business all of a sudden?
Well, when we finally leave this god's forsaken dunghole, I plan to reclaim my heritage, the titles and estates that are rightfully mine.
Got plans for all these lands and titles?
I'll take possession of them. Of course, there's also the issue of progeny.
Is that so? Then you finally found a lassie worthy of the great dandelion.
My dear friend and companion, why, my heart belongs to the one and only Priscilla, known also as Calinetta.
Your heart, mate, true. But the rest of your anatomy?
I resent the insinuation, and hasten to remind you that you are talking to a count.
No need for the count to get riled. Rather, you told us how your beloved is.
She's recovered. Back to full health, physically, mentally, almost.
Recovered? What did I miss?
Ah, right. Ended up not hearing about it?
She was attacked around the time you were in Novigrad. Bugger hurt her something awful.
But, as I said, she's getting better. Even started performing again. Thank the gods.
Give her my best.
Don't worry, I will. Give her a kiss, even. A bit from you, mostly from me.
I'm going rabbit hunting. Dandelion?
Glad to have some rabbit stew. But freezing my ass off to amass the ingredients, did not sign up for that. I'll gather the herbs. Spices. No stew is complete without some sun-drenched thyme and the aroma of rosemary.
Aye, the fields are covered by rosemary blooming like wild just before Yule, aren't they?
That's why I'll be gathering my herbs from the kitchen.
So long.
Got it tough. You've a roof over your head, that's something. When the black ones lay siege to the sea.
Gun cold.
Hey! Bloody hell!
Out on a hunt, Master Witcher? Thought you'd clear the area of beasts your last time through.
Rabbit hunting this time around.
Ah, so that's it. Maybe you come round, visit us this eventide. Verka's baking a pie.
I don't know if...
As you will. You're always welcome.
She's gone.
Mad she had to wait.
No, eager to roam the fields. Prepared the cover scents and oiled the jaw traps all by herself.
Make a good hunter, wouldn't she?
Nah, too impatient, that one. Probably snatching rabbits barehanded, putting them in the traps because they're too slow to step in themselves.
Where'd she go?
Not far, over yonder.
Farewell. Not up to hunting rabbits anymore?
Not really.
What now?
Nothing. Just sitting, waiting for you. It's nice here.
I'll wait till you see Dol Blathana in winter, and the Blue Mountains. We'll head east soon as the snow melts. I think we might have settled in a bit too much.
You promised to show me that griffin's nest before we left. Let's go now.
You actually interested?
Absolutely. You said it yourself. A royal griffin's a rare sight.
Not that rare. Venture to say we'll have to slay a couple more before we get back to Kaer Morhen. But if you want to see the nest, it's just up the hill.
Come.
Come on.
We were supposed to train today.
Uh-huh.
Tomorrow at sunup, then? Work you hard like I did in the good old days. Probably been a while since anyone showed you just how much you still have to learn. Almost there. Careful now.
This is no time for you to lecture me.
Ciri, wait. There's something in there.
We really don't need to play hare and hounds.
Ciri.
What now?
What?
A hair faster. That's all it needed to be to rip your shoulder wide open.
But it wasn't, and it didn't. We killed it. What is this about?
You're angry, wanted to unload. But be that careless, and next time...
Don't you understand? There won't be a next time!
Ciri, what are you talking about?
I'm sorry, it's just... it's not a good time.
Wanna head back? All right, enough. Let's go fishing. We bring Dandelion a nice fat perch, and he just might forget about the rabbit stew. Shame he didn't come along. He could use a bit of exertion.
Huh?
I'll be damned.
Should we go?
No, no way. Lake's gotta be full of perch, bream, or pollard. Fresh pollard. Would you like that?
I wouldn't mind some, but do we plan to wait here until he leaves?
No. We'll scare him off.
How?
I'll improvise. Wait here. An old witcher's trick for tough winters. Not terribly subtle, but...
effective.
Remember, don't ever do this.
Why show it to me at all, then?
Just in case. Never know what could happen on the path, what could save your life. All right, let's go.
Who taught you that?
Vesemir. A long time ago.
How long?
Very. Back when I wanted to call myself Geralt Roger Eric Duot Bellegarcy.
What?
Tell you about it tonight.
And about the time you broke your leg after wagering you'd jump off the roof of Caer Morhen and land a horse's back?
How do you even know about that?
Eskil told me. But I want to hear you tell it. I'm certain you have a rational explanation. Come on. You never gave me piggyback rides at Caer Morhen, remember? Vesemir was the only one willing.
Huh? Had to wait till now to remind me. You've put on some weight since Caer Morhen. Siri.
We should get back.
Remember me training on the pendulum? How I feared I'd never manage. Yet you forbade me from giving up. I was black and blue practically all the time. That pendulum was a nightmare.
How can I forget?
Those months at Caer Morhen, they passed so quickly. I wish we'd spent more time together then. Almost managed to forget it was today. They're here for me, Geralt. I'm going to Nilfgaard, to Ymir. I know you didn't expect this, but in Vizima, my father and I spoke for long. Argued, really, and parted. Then a messenger came with a letter. I didn't say anything at first because I wasn't sure, and then I realized I had to stop fleeing. I realized that if I wish to change anything, I cannot do so hunting monsters round forgotten villages. I must do so from there, from Nilfgaard.
You make this choice on your own?
If you mean to suggest Yennefer had anything to do with this, then the answer is no.
Great. She even know?
No. And I'd prefer she not get involved this time.
I'll let you tell her that. Is this what you want?
Yes. You're not trying to stop me. Take me to the Blue Mountains by force.
Traveled half the world to find you, but I never intended to force anything on you.
I know.
You'll be fine. You're a Witcher.
We needn't say goodbye.
Of course we don't.
I don't know when we'll see each other again.
You know where to find me.
You can't possibly stay at Kaer Morhen all the time.
Makes no difference. You'll find me.
True.
Remember what I taught you. Never know. Could be useful there too.
The Third Northern War ended. The invader from the south achieved complete victory. Robbed of Radovid's tactical genius, the northern realms could not withstand Ymir's countless legions. Black banners appeared over Novigrad and all Redania. Weary of rebel raids, Ymir Var-Emrys conceded, restoring Temeria as a realm in liege to the Empire. When the guerrillas laid down their arms, the Emperor shifted his forces to other fronts. Through Nilfgaard's victory, Temerians got their country back, and history once again proved a consummate trickster. Having dealt with Radovid, Ymir of Var-Emrys did the same with enemies domestic. The Emperor's loyal spies named all who had conspired against him, traitors, soldiers, and aristocrats alike. Though their mutiny had only been a murky plan, the Emperor showed no mercy, as was his wont. Many islanders believed Svanrigga would be no more than his ambitious mother's puppet. The young king proved them wrong, ignoring her whims and ruling with an iron hand all his own. Tired of the Jarls and their endless feuds, he resolved to turn the Isles into an absolute monarchy, modeled after those of the continent. What he resolved, he achieved, but only by shedding his countrymen's blood. After years in exile, Ciri returned to Nilfgaard, her paternal home, where Ymir prepared to name her his successor. The woman had the necessary qualities. From her father, she'd inherited an empress's political instincts. From Geralt, she had gained a sense of simple human decency. Few monarchs boast both traits, which is quite a shame. And what of Geralt, you might ask? Well, he continued on as before, giving hand to mouth, job to job, on the road, ever coinless. We would meet at times over a glass of strong drink to talk about the old days and speculate what could have, would have, might have been.
are you?
You know who I am, and why I'm here.
I do. You needn't. I'm no longer a threat. I starve, for the swamp is poisoned. I've no strength to hunt humans.
Crone summon you?
In my sleep. Once I had wolf dreams. Now I dream hunger, pain, and blood.
Where is she?
Out there, in the swamp. Is there no other way?
There's one. Find the crone. Guide me through the swamp, to her.
And then?
Then we'll see.
Ah, the crone. What's she done to you?
Stole my daughter's medallion.
If I may, why risk it? The crone will fight. Like a hounded wolverine, she'll fight. She may cripple, even kill you. Find the girl a new pendant. Her sorrow will pass in time.
No, it won't. My daughter's dead. Go. What's your name, werewolf?
Barum.
Lead me to the crone, Barum.
There's a wolf den nearby. Wolf cubs inside. Carry them out of the swamp. They'll not survive. I sense a wolf. And men.
How many?
10, no more.
Stay out of it. What are you doing here?
A she-wolf's been on the hunt the last few days. Killed a cow, wounded a man, so we set some traps. Stupid beast walks straight into one. Once she tires, we'll set the hounds on her. Have us a wolf baiting.
What happened to you here?
What does it matter? None of your ploughing concern.
Where's the crone?
Sod off. Your coin's not welcome. Leave our lands.
Not just yet. Soon. First the crone.
You're one. We're 10. We've got hounds. Wanna end like the she-wolf?
Calm down. We don't need to fight.
Just go. And the Lady of the Swamp, you leave her be.
Release the she-wolf.
She's not weakened yet. She's raging. No, she's good as dead, but has yet to accept it.
Get out of here.
What? You dim in the head. Beast killed our cattle, and she'll keep hunting. Damn animal. It's the ploughing enemy. It's her or us.
My sentiments exactly.
We'll flay you alive, you wretch!
Lead me to the crone.
She's close. Somewhere here.
Go back to your wolf dreams, Barum. Save the cub. Go away, far away. Find yourself a comely wife, Wolf, and live.
Let me help you.
No.
Remember, like a hounded wolverine, she'll fight. She could kill you.
I know. Now go.
Patience, sisters. I sense him. He comes. You shall yet have his soul. His pain, his icy suffering will be yours, and you will feast on him. Soon, sisters. Very soon.
Come out.
I sense your pain. I see your fear. Look about you. Feel their hatred. You slaughtered their brethren for a fistful of coin. They would see you suffer while you've lost your claws, Wolf. The prophecies do not lie. You cannot survive this struggle. Cyril is dead. Naught but a small frozen corpse in an icy wilderness. And you are afraid. You feel fear.
You lie. I don't feel a thing anymore.
You've changed. You suffer. You seek death, I feel it. I know the smell of a serpent's breath. The omens do not lie. That little fire. Her cursed blood. She slew my sister. It's your doing. Devours you like maggots devour a corpse.
I can't believe this. You must die.
Stay out of it.
You've changed. You suffer. You seek death, I feel it. I know the smell of a suicide. The omens do not lie. That little whore, her cursed blood. She slew my sisters. I am alone. Tis your doing. Despair devours you like maggots devour a corpse. You are flesh cured with toxins, sweet with pain. You wish to die, Witcher! You wish your suffering to end!
The Third Northern War was a clash between two great strategists, Radovid V, known as the Stern, and Emir Var Emrys. Both seemed invincible, yet both were defeated. Nilfgaard, invading from the south, was repelled in the field, while the North's supreme leader fell victim to assassins. Yet Redania stood victorious, and a man who had thus far operated in shadow took up the reins of power. That man was Sigismund Dijkstra. Once firmly in the Chancellor's seat, Dijkstra ruled the victorious North in his patently cynical and ruthless manner. He knew that to preserve peace, he would need to prepare for war. Following Nilfgaard's example, he consolidated his rule over vast lands through a broad program of settlement and industrialization, all for the good of his subjects, though often contrary to their will. As long as his armies went from one victory to the next, Emir's subjects remained boundlessly obedient. When a string of humiliating defeats proved Var Emrys fallible, the opposition, thus far secret, attacked. The subjects of the Emperor who had danced on the graves of his foes laid him to rest in a tomb of his own. Many islanders believed Svanrigga would be no more than his ambitious mother's puppet. The young king proved them wrong, ignoring her whims and ruling with an iron hand all his own. Tired of the Jarls and their endless feuds, he resolved to turn the Isles into an absolute monarchy, modeled after those of the continent. What he resolved, he achieved, but only by shedding his countrymen's blood. As for Ciri, that's hard to say, since the events on Unvik, she is yet to be seen.